What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. So, today's video is not one that I wanted to make, but I've told you guys in the past that I share everything. So, I made a mistake on my intake install. Luckily, it is fixable, but I wanted to share it with you, and I wanted to share the process on how I'm going to fix it. So, let's take a look. So, as you guys probably know, there are 10 bolts that hold down the intake manifold. They look kind of like this. So, when I was looking at the torque specs, it said 89 foot-pounds. Actually, that's what my head told me it said. It actually said 89 inch-pounds. Now, if you didn't know, there's 12 inch-pounds per foot-pound. So you do the math, that's a lot more. So I ended up breaking off, luckily, only one of these bolts in my cylinder head. So right here, it was actually the first bolt that I went to tighten or torque down, and it felt like it was going so easy that I don't know. Obviously, I was using the wrong tools, I was using the wrong measurements, and it snapped. So, we need to extract the head of that bolt in there. Honestly, this is one of my worst fears, is breaking off a bolt in either the cylinder head or the engine block. But we did it, or I should say I did it, and I need to deal with it. So I'm going to share this with you, and hopefully it's a lesson learned and a lesson for all of you guys as well, to pay attention to the torque specs, and when it says foot-pounds versus inch-pounds, make sure you're using the right torque wrench and the right measurements. So let's go ahead and get the tools that we need, and let's correct this issue. So first thing we're gonna do is tape up all the holes except the one that obviously we're gonna be working on, and make sure no metal shavings get into the engine. Then I went and picked up some tools this morning. I've got a center punch and a left-handed drill bit. If you didn't know, most normal drill bits go clockwise, right-handed. Left-handed is basically only used in this circumstance. So hopefully, one of two things will happen. Either when I go to drill the bolt, it'll grab and it'll just spin the bolt out of the hole as I'm drilling it, or I'll have to drill the whole bolt out. Either way, I'm going to be drilling. So first we need to center punch the center of that bolt, so the drill bit's not walking all over the place. So let's go ahead and take a look. So that is what it looks like currently. We just want to make sure that we use that center punch and get a nice clean punch right in the middle, because when we go to drill, we don't want it to go to one side or another and end up getting into the threads in the cylinder head. That would be bad. So let's go ahead and give it a shot.
As I'm drilling this, it's actually spinning the bolt. This is actually really good. Oh, it's actually partially out of the hole now. Let's keep going. I don't know if you can actually tell, but the tip of the bolt is actually just kind of sticking out of the hole now. As I was drilling, it was kind of backing itself out. So let's see if it can keep going.
Well, guys, I just got extremely lucky. I didn't catch it on video, but as you saw, I started drilling a hole in the top of this, and I got some pretty good depth in there, and then I just upsized the bit slightly to a bigger bit and started to drill in very slowly. And as I was drilling, it just slowly spun its way out of the hole. I didn't even have to drill any deeper. So the whole thing came out. I don't believe any of the threads in the hole are damaged. I'm gonna check that here real quick. Gonna blow out the hole with some compressed air. So I blew out the hole with compressed air just to get any little fragments out of the hole. Now I've got another one of these bolts here. I'm just gonna test it out. Make sure it's straight. And it appears to be spinning in just fine. So, I think I dodged a bullet. Wow. Unbelievable. You guys don't even understand how big of a relief that is that that came out that easy. I was, I've been trying to clear my head for about 2 days now. You know, when something like that happens, you debate in your mind if you even need that bolt. You know, just slap the intake manifold on without that bolt. But I try to do everything right, especially on YouTube. You know, I know you guys are critical, but also I like to do stuff right. But man, that, what a relief. So I do have some spare of those long bolts. Actually, the fast intake came with some, so I'm probably gonna end up using the ones that it came with. They're a little bit shorter, but they still have plenty of thread on them. So I think I'm just gonna go ahead and use those instead of the stock bolts. They look a little nicer anyways. But now I know, use inch pounds instead of foot pounds. So lesson learned there, and I hope you guys may have learned a lesson as well. So don't do what I just did. Also, while I was contemplating in my head what I was going to do about this issue, my throttle body was finished at the polishers. It looks amazing. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. Just look at that. That is like a nice piece of jewelry right there. That's gonna look amazing once I get it on the car. I don't even wanna touch it, get my fingerprints all over it. But just look at that. Much better job than I can do here at the garage with a hand drill. That's awesome. So I'm going to attempt round number two of installing this intake manifold tonight, and hopefully I will be able to finish up that video for you guys. So stay tuned for that. Got a few more other projects to go. I still got a few projects to wrap up as well. So stay tuned for that. Plenty more videos here to come. So I hope you guys enjoyed this one. Lessons learned. If you did, please smash that thumbs up button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. And until next time, we'll see you guys later. Take care.